They know who did it.
Not that they're saying. They want John Paul to go in and give a statement.
Well, that'll be purely procedural. Although, in most murder cases, the assailant is known to the victim.
George was a policeman. So it could have been a criminal he'd put behind bars. So he can nip that theory in the bud.
Sorry, I was merely stating facts.
Well, keep your facts to yourself. I don't need to hear this right now. My cousin's boyfriend has just been murdered, okay?
Well, that was uncalled for.
So George's threat to have me arrested for sexual assault, I guess that's gone away now, right?
It just goes to show. Every cloud has a silver lining.
James, could I have a word, please? It's about John Paul.
Yeah, of course. How is he?
Well, he's in bits, as you can imagine. D.S. Cohen called him in for a statement, but now he's got it in his head that he's responsible.
For killing George?
They had a fight yesterday. And now he thinks that George collapsing is a delayed reaction to John Paul punching him.
Guys like George are going to have a lot of enemies.
Someone should have warned him. You live by the sword, you risk dying by it too.
Could you go in and ask to see him? I'd feel a lot happier if he wasn't alone.
It doesn't really work like that, but I could make a call, see what the situation is.
Okay.
It's like James told Theresa, the police quiz in John Paul. It's fairly standard. They always start close to home.
Yeah, they'll probably want to interview the rest of the family too.
Including me?
Yeah. So you best get your alibi straight.
Well, they might want to talk to you too.
Why? George was sadly no friend of mine.
Exactly. I just hope they find whoever did this quickly. The last thing that John Paul needs is for his private life to become sordid gossip. See you.